Hello everyone. This tutorial shows you how to run the BDB DICOM sample program on Windows mobile devices. You can get the latest program from the OTN network using the URL shown at the bottom of the screen. The DICOM client directory contains the source code for a client program deployable on Windows mobile devices implemented with the Berkeley DB API. The DICOM client SQL directory contains the same client program implemented with the Berkeley DB SQL interface. The DICOM server directory contains the source code for an application server that sits between a backend Oracle database and front-end Windows mobile devices. The docs directory contains documentations for this sample program. The Oracle DB SQL directory contains SQL scripts for creating a sample database. In addition to this tutorial, you can also refer to the installation guide in the docs directory. It contains detailed instructions of how to run this program. Now we are ready to create our sample database. We have included a few SQL scripts to help you create the sample database. You can also find many sample DICOM files under the DICOM folder. Since we are going to execute scripts from files, it is convenient to start your SQL class under the Oracle DB SQL directory. Our sample program requires an Oracle database instance with DICOM extension installed. The sample table requires a table space with automatic segment space management. We can create one for this user. Now we can create the table. And the indexes. We also need to create a directory object pointing to the directory containing sample DICOM files. Now we create the image import procedure and use it to import two DICOM files. Now we can check that our sample database contains two DICOM files. Now we have created our sample database. Now let's turn to the application server. Before compiling the application server, you may need to edit the DICOM server.java file. And make sure the Oracle database connection information is correct. Now we compile and start the server. The server is now started on port 8080. Let's complete the picture with the client program. Open the client program in Visual Studio. modify the IP address in the DICOM service file to the IP address of the application server. You may also need to adjust a few properties according to your local environment. For example, the include directory. And the library directory. After a successful build of the client program, we can run it in an emulator. Take Windows Mobile Pocket PC as an example. We connect to the emulator and create a DICOM folder under the root directory. Start the client program. After the client is started in the emulator, click Download. If you see this error message, you need to enable network for the emulator. Click Configure, Network, and enable the network adapter. And click Download again. Now we see that we have successfully downloaded two DICOM images from the application server. We can also open them to see the DICOM attributes. And images. We can also query downloaded images. This completes the tutorial. Thanks for your interest and time.